tyrants of Cyrodiil, don't get your hopes up. They're just a sad bunch of warriors living in the past.
Great to have you back in action, sir.
Yeah, unlike Lilith. Where is she anyway? So I've been doing some research, and it seems this tunnel links up to the mountainside right next to the Pale Pass. Hope our sisters make it through. Now, are we leaving? About time. Something you need? Glad you asked. Maline would say I'm a walking library.
Don't flatter yourself.
Right in the middle of the Draw Mountain Range, specifically next to the legendary Pale Pass. When the Akaviri invaded Tamriel in the First Era, they captured an Imperial fortress in the area. It wound up being a big mistake. Low on supplies, they failed to hold onto it for long. Some say they still wander the fortress, patrolling the halls and waiting for reinforcements. If we're lucky, the recent avalanches might have spilled a few undead warriors onto our end. I'd like to test my mettle against my ancestors and give them the fight they've craved for centuries. And, of course, to show Maline a thing or two about respect. During the Great War, you would get a few well-meaning refugees coming through here. These days, it's fallen into the hands of bandits and smugglers. I see no reason why anyone would bother using it unless they're desperate. Or ordered by Mistress Matari. It's no secret that the Empire has been clamping down on illegal immigrants from Cyrodiil lately. Too risky for our sisters to try the traditional method of walking in plain sight and dodging Imperial scout patrols. Sure thing. Right behind you, boss.
Take a look around. Might find some rare goods smuggled in from Cyrodiil. That she's wandering around Skyrim taking care of personal business. It's been happening since Pazarath. She's going to get chewed out by the Maidens if she keeps it up. Only that Talia is among them, transporting them to their classified destination. Doubt we'll learn anything until she gets back. Mm-hmm. Let's take care of the bandit leader while we're at it.
Should do it.
Now we wait. Orsinium's sister, what's wrong?
Stand aside. We have wounded coming in.
Take defensive positions. They will not take another life this day. Do you hear me? Gods, damn you!
There's someone there.
Shrapnel wounds from the explosives. Got her lungs good.
Well, Juno, take care of her. Who is the commanding officer here? Step forward. A siren man. Today is full of surprises. Not just of Cyrodiil, it seems. But we'll get to that later. My patience runs thin. I want some answers as to why your mistress knowingly and willingly sent us into a hot zone. Oh, really? Well then, I'll have to ask her myself why 25 sirens had to die here today. Either because of her incompetence or because of her perfidious schemes.
Hey, you can't say that about the mistress. You just can't.
She's right. It isn't wise.
I wasn't speaking to either of you. But since your kind is so loyal, so submissive, you won't mind following my orders for the duration of this mission. Juno, Karzak, Scribonia, you three take the two Ashen and defend the northern entrance. This commander and I will hold the line.
As you wish, Yanaria. Move it. Now!
Stand your ground. We will regroup with the others once we've made a large enough dent in their forces to get us out of here alive.
There's someone there.
work, Simon. You may walk among seducers, but you are a warrior. Now follow. We will regroup with the others and leave this blasted tunnel.
Again, Dragonborn. It's too late for that. Lines have been drawn, and Purity wants nothing to do with you after Pazarath. You're on your own. But that doesn't mean I can't help you. I'm here to warn you about something. Something big. Purity hasn't said anything, but it won't be too long before they show us all what they've been working on. Have the Sirens told you about the Westweald massacre that happened almost 50 years ago? The Pinder family was almost wiped out that day after returning from the Black Marsh. No one except Purity knows what caused them to go rampant. I have a feeling we're about to see the cause. Here, a log from a Purity alchemist working on our mystery project. All the details are there. A Hiss tree. Blackwood Company. History is about to repeat itself, and I might be the only one who can stop it. It's time for me to play with fire. Dragonborn, no matter what happens, remember what I'm fighting for, and stay out of my way. I don't want to kill you if I don't have to, but things have changed. The only way that we can save this world now is if we do what must be done. I'm going to destroy innocence, but to do that, I need to make a sacrifice. The next time you see me, I'll be with Purity. Then I'll have to kill you, else I lose my cover. Easier said than done when Mitari has you on a leash. If you're planning on doing something too, you better do it soon. That's enough for today. You've led the rats out of their maze, and I've wasted enough men chasing them. All we can do is wait and pray to whatever gods are watching over us for the strength to do what comes next. If we both get out of this war alive, you'll know where to find me. Skies divide. A solution to all of our problems. All roads lead there. But whether you arrive as an ally or enemy will all depend on what happens next. Goodbye, Dragonborn.
your gear and prepare to move out. Ashen, return to your designated posts. I find the commander to be a more fitting escort to the palace. We may speak outside. I suppose we have a minute. We are humble servants of the Pinder family. Our personal histories are kept to ourselves. But like all true warriors, life doesn't begin until you've held your first blade. Who is this Matari? Where was she when the sirens called Cyrodiil home? Away in Arcavir, collecting ashen slaves? To learn that she had become the new leader of the Sirens on top of Marcus's death was revolting. Make no mistake, Siren. Matari's rise to power is not by chance. The corpses piling at her feet are due in part to carefully orchestrated maneuvers. I thought you might. You do not have the glazed eyes of your ashen companions. Are there others like you? If so, why hasn't anyone spoken out? Allow me to be the first. When we enter the Euphoria Palace, Matari will give us our answers. The rest of the Sirens of Cyrodiil. The heroes had the high ground as we trudged through the valley. We were completely outnumbered. Matari promised safe passage, and look what she got us into. You call her a capable leader? Marcus would be ashamed if he was still alive.
With honor. A look into their history reveals a tragedy of murder and woe. There are families all over Tamriel that cry out for help. No matter how hard you try, you can't save them all, but the Pinders. And they mounted an army out of nothing but the sheer will to survive. You can't save them all. But I'd be damned if I didn't try.
It's a palace buried deep beneath the ground near the Cyrodiil-Valenwood border, east of Skingrad, in what is known as the West Weald region. A long time ago, it served as a brothel, much like Euphoria, and was owned by a purity-funded warlord known as Dasan. When he perished at the turn of the era, the palace was abandoned. That is, until the Pinders claimed it for their own use. For over 100 years, it has served as the staging grounds for the Pinder family's war with the Purity, first under the control of the Cleansers, and then Serenity's Sirens. There was a major transfer to Euphoria 10 years ago, when Purity activity was detected here in Skyrim. Only a few of us remained at the Cyrodiil Palace. The weaklings in the eyes of Matari, apparently. No Ashen, just men and myrrh. The predecessors of the Sirens, founded in 77 by Martin Pinder, son of Lucy and the Ascending. They were valiant knights in lieu of the Fighters Guild. Just as the Sirens maintained themselves through secondary contracts, so did they. But fighting in the name of the Pinder family came first. They lived a good lifespan, 78 years. From Morrowind to High Rock, they held a bloody war with Purity when they still had the gall to fight out in the open. Then the West Weald massacre happened. Matari never told you. No surprise that she would want the Sirens to forget the great disaster that brought us here today. If you have the time, read this book. It may be from a regular guardsman from Skingrad, but he knows as much as we do. Only a Pinder would know. Like the Holy Matrons, Master Marcus never spoke of him. The timing of the one's disappearance raises a few questions that we may never get answered. Did he die, or did he abandon the family he created? Early Pinder history is filled with sexual promiscuity brought on by Purity's accursed Eros sap and the Matrons. A part of me doesn't want to know the truth. That there is little to be said about her and her more implied affiliations?
Could it be possible that she never died and is still in this fabled land of the Matrons? The Matrons may have served the Pindars in the previous century, but their absence today begs the question if they ever truly cared for them at all. If Faustina is still alive in some shape or form, I wonder if she even calls herself a Pindar. Certainly.
If you want to talk, talk to Yanaria.
Well, hello.
What do you need?
Statue of the Sun. Matari must have an atrocious taste in sculptures. The master would have had it demolished the moment he saw it.
Welcome back! Yes! Zana was worried, so she asked Matari to speak with me. Personally! She said they'd be back in a week or two. But then everything will be back to normal. Of course! It means that nothing bad is going to happen to our sisters. Matari also promised the war would be over soon. She said everything is going according to plan. Can you believe it? We'll finally have peace! We'll be free! Oh, where are my manners? Go right in. She can't wait to meet all of you.
I can't believe they're all... I don't know what to say. Matari, she'll tell you. Kathy, I'm so sorry.
A hug and a pat on the head is all you need to be happy. The bubbly teacher that's friends with everyone. She did good work training Grace, but she forgot to show her a few pointers. I'd rather show than tell. You know, this war will be over soon. That calls for a celebration. We could take some time off and just relax in my room. We've earned it, don't you think? Always the big hero, huh? I like that. But just in case you change your mind, I'll check up on you again after your next assignment. You're going to need the happiness to get you through this last stretch of the war. Come count on it.
Matari is waiting.
Matari.
Welcome to Euphoria Palace, Commander Yenaria. What have you to report?
The death of 25 Sirens, gutted by the heroes. Their blood is on your hands.
We were not aware that heroes were stationed in the Gerals. We will look into their activity on the border.
Don't gratify me.
You should show respect towards our leader, dear sister.
I only bow before the Pindars, not this woman. This false prophet.
Rude!
Shut it, nymph. I'll deal with you soon enough.
Oh no! You shouldn't have said that!
Lower your weapon. Your skepticism is understandable. But I can assure you that this order still upholds the values set forth by the Pindar family. Our original purpose to defend them is very much alive.
Where is Master Marcus's daughter?
At Fort Pazarath. She will be leaving soon for an assignment.
What madness is this? Master Marcus would never approve of Kasha's enlistment.
This was her personal rec...
Are you more indulged in your pompous agenda than I imagined? She's our responsibility, dear sister. My team and I are leaving for Pazarath this instant. If the Sirens will not defend her, then we will.
Your orders are to remain here and defend the palace.
Have your putrid little wenches do it for you. There's nothing worth saving in this rotten place. I know your game, seducers. If you wish to murder me, you'll need to do more than just beguile me into a corner. I'm not as weak-willed as your usual victims.
Maidens, leave us. The Commander and I must discuss the situation regarding the absent Sirens. They're all dead.